tener una esperanza en contra de esta pandemia. Tener una esperanza en contra de esta pandemia.
The coronavirus has never been isolated, purified, characterized, which means its genome has never been properly, you know, described. And if that's the case, then there's no possible way to do a surrogate test to find a virus which has actually never been found. It's simply impossible. So that means, as I've said over and over again, PCR tests don't have false positives and false negatives. They have falses. And that's different. And so I don't like even people referring to false negatives and false positives. I think John probably would agree with that. And then the final thing is, if you don't have an isolated virus, then you can't possibly demonstrate that the virus is the cause of any disease. And that's essentially where we're at. And, you know, just to reiterate that, there was a very good expose of the first paper that really described this, how to do a PCR test for this new coronavirus. And I've read this a million times. And they said, you know, quote, this is the Christian Drosten paper. "We aim to develop and deploy robust diagnostic methodology for use in public health laboratory settings without having the virus material available," which means they don't actually have the virus. The CDC, as John also has pointed out on page 39 of their June bulletin, said they have no quantified virus available. That's virology talk for we don't ever have the virus, we've never isolated it. So people, I don't know, unfortunately, but they keep sending me papers claiming isolation. I assume they probably do with John. And there's even been some people who have tried to debunk at least what I'm saying and say, how could anybody say that it hasn't been isolated? Here's 10 papers that show, or at least in the title, claim isolation. And as I just said to John, I'm a little bit tired of this. And so I thought I would have John on, and we would actually go through, starting with John, what does it mean to isolate a virus? And I know that's a little bit of a long-winded introduction, and if there's anything you heard, John, that you didn't, you would disagree with or like to change, I'm happy to hear it. But if not, if you could say whatever you want, and then literally tell us what we mean by isolating a virus.
First of all, it's great to be here talking to you, Tom. And I would say isolating the virus means that you separate it out from all surrounding material. In other words, it's the dictionary definition. You right. Isolate somebody in a room. What does that mean? It means you take them away from all other people and you put them alone. Well, in this case, that's what people would think scientists mean when they say we isolated the virus. It's maybe involved in some kind of soup of material and we somehow managed to extract it from everything else, from other genetic material, from other germs, from chemicals, from contaminants. It's pure, alone. Here it is. We could take an electron microscope picture of it and show it to you. It would be very clear. And in fact, when you referred to one of my initial articles on the subject, what I said was, why didn't they do this with, say, 500 people at the very beginning? We say these 500 people are all suffering from the pandemic disease. So we line them up and we take tissue samples from each one. And we go through a process of purification, isolation. We spin this material in a centrifuge. We know that different density gradients settle out at different levels. We find the layer where we think the virus is. We go through all of this very meticulous procedure, and we end up with 500 side-by-side, very clear electron microscope photographs from each one from each patient. And we compare them.